Sunflower oil is a versatile oil that can be used for frying, baking, and even salad dressings. It's a popular cooking oil because it has a high smoke point, so it can be heated to high temperatures without burning. It is also low in saturated fat and high in unsaturated fats, making it a healthier option than other cooking oils. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at how sunflower oil is produced. Sunflowers usually grow in warm climates and need lots of sunlight. Farmers must ensure that sunflowers receive the right amount of water and nutrients to grow properly, so they are watered and fertilized frequently to ensure they grow to their full potential. The seeds are sown in spring, and flowering begins in summer. As the sunflower matures, reaching impressive heights of up to 12 feet, the vibrant yellow color of the flower heads gradually fades from brown or yellow. Additionally, as the flower matures, the bright and prominent petals of the sunflower begin to fall, a visible sign that the flower has completed its reproductive cycle and is ready to be harvested. It is essential for farmers to closely monitor the development and harvest at the right time. As sunflowers mature, their heads may droop or tilt downward, which is a normal response to the weight of the seed. And the seeds should come out of the head easily when gently rubbed or touched. This ease of separation indicates that the seeds are fully developed and ready for harvest. Sunflower harvesting is an important step in producing high-quality sunflower oil, and precise timing is essential to ensure optimal yield and product quality. The choice of harvest day is important. The ideal conditions are sunny and dry, with low humidity. These climates are essential in reducing seed moisture, soothing the cutting and handling process, preventing head damage, and ensuring seed integrity. Modern agriculture has adopted specialized machinery to harvest sunflowers and efficiently extract their seeds in large quantities. Combines, large self-propelled machines equipped with cutting blades and threshing mechanisms, play a pivotal role in this process. As the combine maneuvers through the sunflower fields, its cutting blades sever the sunflower heads from the stalks. The heads are then conveyed into the machine's threshing chamber, where a series of rotating drums delicately extract seeds from flower heads, ensuring minimal loss of seeds. An average of 1 acre of land can produce 1 to 1.2 tons of sunflower seeds. After sorting, the sunflower seeds are carefully loaded onto a truck and transported to the processing plant, where they are turned into sunflower oil. After the seeds have been delivered to the factory, they undergo a comprehensive inspection and are subsequently unloaded for further processing. The initial stage of this process involves the cleaning and sorting the seeds. This is important because it helps to get rid of any unwanted things, like dirt or rocks that might have gotten mixed in during the harvesting process. Now sunflower seeds need to be dried. Specially designed drying machines, capable of handling the fragile characteristics of sunflower seeds, carefully transport the seeds through a sequence of chambers. As the seeds progress through the machine, they are exposed to a constant stream of heated air, meticulously regulated to guarantee optimal drying while maintaining quality, resulting in a dry state that is suitable for the subsequent phase of processing. Sunflower seed dehulling is a multi-step process that efficiently separates the edible kernels from protective shells. First, the sunflower seeds are introduced to a machine through a hopper, where they are carefully fed into the system. Then they pass through a roller that applies pressure to crack the husks, exposing the inner kernels. The partially exposed seeds are then separated through a sieve, which separates them from the hull based on their size and weight. This meticulous sorting process ensures that only the desirable seeds go forward. Then the sunflower seeds undergo a roasting process to elevate their flavor and aroma. It also helps to make the kernels more manageable to crush. The roasting process involves exposing the kernels to controlled heat, typically within a range of 250 degrees Fahrenheit to 350 degrees for a specified duration. The roasting time and temperature are carefully calibrated to achieve the desired level of flavor development and texture without compromising the seed's nutritional value. Now, the edible kernels are ready for oil extraction. The roasted seeds are placed in a specialized machine called an oil press. This powerful machine applies pressure to the seeds. effectively crushing them and releasing the precious oil trapped within. It has a big cylinder and a spinning screw. When the screw turns, it applies pressure to the seeds and squeezes out the oil. The pressure is typically maintained within the range of 400 to 500 bar. It forces the oil to flow out through tiny openings in the cylinder while the solid residue known as the cake is expelled from the other end. This sunflower seed cake is rich in protein and other essential nutrients, making it suitable for animal feed. The temperature inside the mechanical presses must be maintained below 104 degrees Fahrenheit to prevent oil degradation and preserve its flavor and aroma. Skilled press operators continuously monitor and adjust the speed, pressure, and temperature settings to ensure optimal oil extraction. Approximately 40 to 50% of the oil is extracted from the sunflower kernels. On average, 1 ton of sunflower kernels yields about 420 to 480 liters of oil. This can vary depending on several factors, including the seed variety, moisture content, and extraction method. Once the oil and cake are separated, the oil undergoes a thorough filtration process to remove any solids or sediments that may be present in the oil. However, it is currently not fit or suitable for eating. For human consumption, the oil needs to be refined. It ensures the required quality and safety standards. The refining process of sunflower oil generally involves multiple stages. Neutralization removes free fatty acids and other acidic compounds, stabilizing the oil and preventing rancidity. Bleaching removes any residual pigments or color, creating a clear and bright appearance. Deodorization eliminates essential compounds, such as odors, enhancing the oil's aroma and taste. After refining, the oil is cooled to the appropriate temperature and stored in clean, sterile containers. It is then subjected to a rigorous quality analysis to ensure that it meets the highest purity and safety standards. Once the oil has passed the quality analysis, it's ready to be bottled. The bottling process is carefully designed to ensure the oil maintains its quality and longevity. The bottles are carefully filled with sunflower oil, ensuring that no air or impurities are introduced. In addition to the airtight packaging, the bottles are labeled with important information for consumers. This information tells us important things, like what nutrients it has, when it expires, and how to store it. After that, the bottles are put into a box and made ready for people to buy and use. Proper storage is essential to maintain the freshness and quality of sunflower oil. It's recommended to store the oil at room temperature, away from direct sunlight and heat sources. With proper storage, sunflower oil can maintain its freshness and quality for up to 1 year, making it a reliable and versatile option for all your culinary needs. And there you have it, folks, the process of making sunflower oil. It is a healthier option than other cooking oils, making it a popular choice among health-conscious individuals. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, and you can watch it.